Sydney quick sales order entry and put in TZ.
Out of Branchville?
Yes. Remember how you would change this if it was the wrong account. He's in a order now. Let's say it's the wrong account. Let's say it's BC Electric out of Little Silver. While in a ticket, how would you change it from TZ Electric to BC Electric?
You gotta go to the header.
Edit where? Go back. Go back to the body. Yeah,
edit and
shift. Put it up here.
Right.
You're going to edit and shift, right? Yep.
Put it
in BC. It's going to ask, are you going to change your ship to address to new customers? Yes. This is where you could either reprice all the items, change it back to list price. So we're just going to go, yep, reprice it. We haven't given anybody a quote, so hit OK. Hit OK. So now we went from TZ to BC Electric. So within the ticket, you can change it if you have the wrong customer. Are there any questions? So he's doing it out of Parsippany, but let's say he wants to do this out of Tinton Falls. How would you change the ship to branch from inside the ticket?
From where?
No. Do you know what that is?
That's
you know
price.
What branch that that's talking about?
Price branch.
It's your pricing branch. Okay? That's who's pricing the ticket. We're not going based off of the pricing branch either when it comes to the invoicing. For EDEPs and credit, it's still the shipping branch. Okay? This is just, Chris is from New Brunswick. He's in the New Brunswick pricing branch. So how would you change this? Nope. All right, go ahead. Go back to the body.
Edit order.
Ship branch.
Where are we shipping out of?
Yep. Tinton Falls. And you can see on the bottom, it's got your pricing branch in New Brunswick. Your shipping branch of Tinton Falls. So fill this out like you would, like you're going to complete the order. He's going to want this, go back to that. We're going to do that as a delivery. Give shipping instructions of please deliver tomorrow. So what's the next status that we're going to do?
We want to deliver it tomorrow.
Go to ship when specified. You're going to select your date.
So it is, say it's the 12th, right?
Today's 13th. Looks good. Now, before he selects this, does everybody understand what that printing option is for? The printing option. Acknowledgements. changed the shift. So the printing is just for an announcement, just for personal copy. Without walking in the back. So when he does go to print.
Or say, I can see it with that print.
Okay. So, up top, next to items, go over to it. Go one more. Log. You click on log, it's going to give you the log. And it'll give you that at print. So, obviously, we didn't print anything yet. But at the very bottom of it, this is literally giving you every single thing you've done in this invoice.
But if you hit print, can you go back to that?
Can you go back into this?
Yeah
absolutely. Yeah. So, X out.
Don't print an acknowledgement. Leave that as an option.
And there's one more question.
Yeah.
Is there any default on the ship status on hurdle list? What do you mean? Well, you don't have to put in. There's no default that's going to ship for next day.
No.
I don't ask you.
No, because this system is based on all dates, so it wants you to pick that date to know the print. So it's going to print that thing the day before, so it's all based off of the date. It's not going to say tomorrow.
Well, it's default for the current date, right?
Yeah,
if
you don't enter the
date
it.
Yeah.
So that would print the date.
That's the question.
Well, but the second that you would go to ship to specified, it's going to bring you right to the calendar.
Yeah.
And then your first date is going to be on, it's going to be today's date. Actually, no, you still have to select today's date, right?
Yeah, you still have to select today's date.
Yeah, you still have to select today's date.
Yeah.
Not just select the date no matter what.
Yeah.
All right, so.
Go before you got out of it, you go back to print.
So, X out. Now. Go back to the search bar. Nope. Go back up to the
this one?
The TF one.
Okay.
So what would be the fastest way to go back into this ticket? What would be the fastest way to find that ticket that you just did?
We gotta press E.
What's up? Just type in depending on your parameters that you set for the widget.
Listen to Grant.
Graham's telling you right now. So, right up top there, the most recent, the 1223 BC, click on that.
Is what you've done.
Yeah. Okay. So yes.
Yeah. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
So do your favor.
You know what I don't like? It doesn't show you a order.
Well,
yeah, right here.
Your order number is on the very, very,
very small.
Top left too, no?
Yeah. So Freddie, to also answer your logging question, if you click on file when you're in the body of the ticket.
Oh.
You have order shipment details. So click on order shipment details. This would actually tell you if the Phantom was processing. It would tell you if it was waiting to print, if it was open. This tells you about all your generations in one second.
It says it there, but
unfortunately, it's not opening up on the screen.
Well, it says waiting for Phantom to print.
All right, there you go.
So it hasn't picked it up yet.
Phantom.
Yeah, so it actually hasn't printed yet, but so do you know how often it's going to run where you print tickets?
When we were talking to them about this, for anything that is either a delivery on today's date or tomorrow's date, we have to give it a time interval. So we could do it every minute or every 2 minutes. So that's what we're going to do, because obviously we want these orders coming out as soon as they're really printed. So it'll be every 1 or 2 minutes that this thing will run. Deliveries for either today.
Now, here's a big question. I have a lot of this. I get a lot of orders at 2:30, 4:30, I have to be out the door by 3 o'clock to go to the shop. Okay. Is that going to be
It's every 1 or 2 minutes.
If I actually have to put it in bid, send it out, get the PO, come back, write the order, then go. I can do that in about 30 orders.
Yeah,
or 40
minutes.
That's why I'm getting that right now.
Right, so we've been assured that, you know, running this Phantom every minute, every 2 minutes, like, oh, could that cause some hiccups that we're running this thing so often? And they've assured us that's never been an issue. That you can run this thing as much as you want.
There's no way to change the Phantom.
You have to do it at interval. It's not really just the right
second.
I would imagine that's possible, especially with all the other companies that do use the system. I mean with all the other companies that do use the system, I'm sure that
that's why I was getting that. How do I know it has to be written?
And that's what I'm saying.
If you do not, now I have to go,
So when you go into the orders, you're definitely going to want to go into the file order shipment detail, because that's going to tell you all of your status and everything that's active and what's going on. See? Exit out of this, and you can exit out of the ticket.
Okay. Let me just ask you
to make sure. All right, thank you. So were there any questions about changing the contractor in that ticket, changing the shipping branch, any questions at all? Yeah. All right. Mr. Raleigh, come on up. All right, we're going to stay logged in to Chris real quick.
Anything new that
didn't
come in before?
Be nice, I'm going to receive
him.
Nice.
Got you.
Be nice, come on, baby.
Switching. All right, so. Well, I'm gonna need it just for now, still on Christmas. So, what's the fastest way back into a ticket? No, you gotta be in a search bar.
I gotta be inside of a widget.
Yeah, inside of a widget. Click F10. All right, so you're gonna go into the first order.
Here's the question why you're doing that. You have to be in a...
Come on, Frederick.
Alright, so, customer called back and said, you know what, I need 20 of these. So he's going to need 20 of these RAB rails. But we're not going to have 20 in stock. We're going to have to cut a PO for them. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to change our quantity to 20.
Grab them all, or
so
from the screen, we're going to grab all 20 from RAD. How would we do that?
Other vendor.
Other vendor. And then
just, we bring it to us or shipping it right to them?
No, we're going to bring it in.
We're going to bring it in.
You're a good
body. Yep. There we go. Now it's going to ask you the vendor name. Put in RAB. We're going to hit OK. Notice what it did to the status. Oh,
one question.
Right back, go to status. Yeah. So there's a couple things with the statuses right now. So right now it did automatically make it a call when complete. So because we do have to wait for it to come in. Another thing that we could do is if we just wanted to send it when it all came in, what would we do?
Ship.
So for this one,
we'll ship when available.
So, but what's the difference between the ship when complete and ship when available? Yeah, I think
you know, if they were sending them from different warehouses, if it's coming from different locations, you know, you get five here, five there, depending on how your customer wants to receive it.
So right now we're going to do ship when complete. So what's the next part in cutting the PO? It's the most important part, how we cut our PO. Procurement confirmation.
Boom.
So we already see we have the item there, procuring from RAB Lighting. We're going to check it. Create PO. What's the next thing that we have to do? In all POs, what's it going to ask us?
Freight.
Now looking at Chris's parameters, click on header. He can't do it.
We don't know this.
So does everybody, just so I know, when everybody cuts a PO, does it say in red, view only?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yep. Okay.
Just make a note that no one is able to cut a PO. You cut a PO, you can't adjust it.
Add freight.
You can send it, you can't modify it.
Yeah, but they're going to send nothing.
Yeah.
All right, so in here for the freight, that's where you would add it. And then, same thing, we're just going to go to the status.
So there definitely has to be something in the freight line. It can't be blank.
Cannot be blank. Freight line has to
have
something.
So you
see
the freight, okay.
That order ID, I'm sorry, if you can go back to the header. Mm-hmm. The order ID, it's not mandatory. But I'm going to tell you right now, when you're trying to look up POs or look up something that you did, it is extremely helpful in finding it faster.
Because that would be your customer job name for the order ID. It's not, you know, not our PO.
Yeah.
What
their job number is the job for.
So try to get in the habit of just putting your customer's job name in that order ID. Ordered with is who you would be cutting the PO, like who would be sending the PO to.
So you, for this, like you would put Kevin Sand or whoever you're dealing with, David, or something like that. But yeah, it's the person you're dealing with at the rent or manufacturer.
Right.
None of the POs are going to be assigned like we listed out that they automatically fax out or go through the EI, correct? They're all going to be coming to us. We want to, you know, we have to modify the PO header 13 or 14 to take off the send.
Yeah, I mean, the only way you're sending it is on the status screen. So you could send it straight from there to RAB or to the rep, but, you know, it's not going to send on that.
It doesn't want to be received, so it's
better to send it. Yeah. But you're also, you're copied on anything you send out.
Ready to be off.
Great, that customer idea, got that. Got it.
How's the pricing for the item you loaded there?
You got, you know, well, how you, or you, or you just relying on what the system said is our price.
The price is going to, well, right now, you're seeing no price.
Right, right now it's not, well, you put, you know, you get it,
you get a lot,
a lot price, no individual.
And do you know what that magic lot number is on the bottom there? It's the actual cost of the item. So when the PO is getting cut, it's getting cut at what our buying number is.
But if we have a job number that we're cutting a PO for, where we're getting better in stock places, we need to enter that for the PO, not the PO.
That's what needs to get fixed in the system.
Right. Right. Now, I'm just looking, I use Rattle, probably a bad one. EMK. I'm picking up Rupert's EMK. That's better than what.
Just a parameter thing right now. That's all it is.
So you will be able to get in there and change that before you set the PO out.
Hopefully, yeah.
Otherwise, the POs are going to be wrong off the manufacturer.
Yeah.
I mean, if that's okay with the company, then that's okay. But we, that's what it comes down to.
It's one of the things that we're trying to figure out the best way to do it. Obviously, we know salesmen need to be able to adjust POs because pricing, you know, varies from any item. So it's something we have to straighten out.
I have non-stop PO that I cut today. The unit cost is zero, but I have the same cost of 43%.
The non-stock item that you got?
It was existing and it was
expected. It was existing?
Yeah, because I heard the guys couldn't cut non-stop units.
And did you pull it from the PDW catalog, or did you pull it from a catalog index?
No, it was something previously created.
And I know that
PDW, and we were creating, when we were using the PDW, we were creating non-stock items that were the cost. It wouldn't allow us to create POs or PLNs. So
and that was everybody.
And that's everybody. Right?
Yes.
Only ones we were able to use are the ones that were pre-existing from the list.
And did you also create them from scratch?
Yeah.
But it doesn't only create a PO, you get that.
No, we spoke about that when we were right there.
Yeah, I'm still having that issue.
Yeah, that's something that I want to say. I checked it out.
Some maybe of them was a real part number, and it just popped up.
Good luck.
I did an auto for those.
Especially if
they're watching, I did Arlington Mason's ULPs for their catalog, and it wouldn't let me create it because I put Arlington, wouldn't let me do it. As soon as I put lemon in it, it would be.
Yeah, I did lemon as well.
I don't know if that's something with the vendor, certain vendors, or
whatever. And I think that may be the case right now. I know that. That's one of the biggest things that they're working on is the PDW file. So it's obviously not perfect right now. We're having nothing but issues. So go to the status of the PO. I would say, me personally, I'd probably email it to myself. So go to print. Let's see if you have that option. Email. And you're going to X out.
Now his is automatically loaded. You have to write his email.
No,
I had to keep put mine at 49.
He's still going to ask for what email you want to send.
Oh, okay.
To.
At some point when we're live, is it going to remember once we type in?
Yeah, it should.
CAF, then it's going to remember my email address.
That is supposed to, like, once you enter it one time, it should just like out.
No, why would they be doing that now? I'd be
I'm still interested in seeing what's going to happen with all the fake stuff that we've already entered, you know? So there's a
I mean, because we're not changing the system. We're going to have 50,000 orders out there.
there's a lot of stuff. There's still going to be a conversion, everything that has to get done. There's still a lot of bugs that need to get worked out. Right now, the key thing is kind of what everybody's doing and messing around with the system and seeing what you are not allowed to do. And that's what we need to know so we can get it fixed.
Yeah.
And you know what I mean? Like I said, we did Tint Falls and we were doing the direct example, so we used Justin Crucius as sign-in, who cuts directs for gear all the time. He didn't have the authority to do a direct. He couldn't even start an order off as. You know, Terry in accounting. So there's definitely issues with certain parameters that need to get fixed out. But the only way that we're really going to find out as to what you're not able to do and should be able to do, because you do it every day, is by you guys messing around with it and then telling us so that we can make note of it and get it fixed.
Now, question with the direct. What's the issue with the print aspect on that, where you have the only allows you to email or any option is go through options for print?
But that's not everybody. And I hate going back to it, but it really is another parameter issue. Mike and myself can do it.
And it gives you the drop down?
Yeah, I get the drop down and I could do it.
Manipulate POs? I can't manipulate, when I do a direct, I can no longer manipulate that ticket for the direct. Because the direct and the PO is the same number.
Correct. Your direct and your PO are going to be the same number.
So the direct ticket and the PO, I can no longer modify once I create it as a direct because I can't modify PO.
Is this with one or two different generations on that ticket?
The second generation or the direct? No, the original generation for the standard order I can manipulate. But the direct goes immediately.
Right. So we're going to do direct.
Well, yeah, we're going to do direct test.
Thank you.
No problem.
Freddie, come on up. Can you log out of Chris and sign in as yourself?
Yeah, I can do that. Oh man, you got to actually mention maybe without a mouse on. God, how do you do this without a mouse? I don't remember, to be honest with you, Mike. Like I said, I get very few times. I guess I was playing on Monday. I was getting to play, got to play with it a little bit, and I was having all kinds of problems. My customers loaded and ready.
Alright, so.
You want me to
go ahead. Pick any one of your customers.
Oh, I'm going to go right to the top one. I'm going to go right to the guy that we probably can. I'm going to do a motion right up there.
You
want
to order, right?
I put in an item, a mouse on it, a direct thing. Can you do all three on one?
Yeah, do you want to do a mouse on it and direct all on one?
Let me do this all on one, and then you can show me exactly what I can't do. Does this always have to come up, or we get rid of this thing? Okay, that's a pain in the ass.
So, first things first, is do you want to...
Hold on, let me put everything on the front of this order, okay?
All right, go ahead.
Let me do like I was going to do regular order and do this. All right. Let's see. Quite a lot of stuff here. Yeah. I'll get to that in a minute. Yeah, I'll just change it. Yeah, see, mine's always started as a bid. Because that's what I want to get to. Because CJ thinks maybe I can't start it as a bid. You can't do it from a bid?
Yeah, I mean you can, but you're still just gonna, you're gonna be.
Well, that's because this is, I'm always in bids before I change anything to orders.
Yeah, you should be able to do your non stops. You just have to be able to cure it until you're
ready. Yeah, you're gonna go back.
Okay, quantity.
Alright, so let's do one.
I'm already 10.
Now, for 10?
I'm already 10. let me put these things in. Jim, you want me to play? Well, I'm playing right now in front of people that you know they should have answers for me.
If you just enter through, it'll get you through the lines. Okay. Going back to the mouse.
You gotta just use tab.
You know, if you just press enter after you put your tab. Quantity, put your thought in, and then enter, you have to make a line.
Yes. What did I have the other day? Oh, yeah. PR 26.
Are you for a position up in order earlier?
That's you thing. All right.
Yes.
All right. There's my non-stock. My non-stock wouldn't go in now. Okay.
Your non-stock wouldn't go
yeah,
in.
That wouldn't, that's the exact part number. I know it's not, it should go in, but it's not. So I can't use an actress, right? You don't want me to use actresses.
No.
So
put the whole part number in.
Okay.
Yeah, just do partial.
All right, let's go like this way. 26, 352. I wanted to do. All right,
so this is actually coming out of the PDW. The reason why I know this is coming out of the PDW is the fact that it's also giving
a UPC
you the default cost. Okay. It has the UPC number in here. Anything that does come up in the PDW, you don't want to modify. Okay. A big part of the PDW is the fact that one, they need all the information. Everything's being streamed into us, price, everything. So when that price goes up, there's a cost increase. It's going to go up. If you adjust something, change something, it's going to lock in there. That's the same thing from when you're creating non-stocks from scratch. When you create a non-stock item from scratch, it's going to be extremely rare. You would leave that default cost to zero. Okay? Because any cost that you would put in there, somebody could sell it, you know, 2 years later, and they may think, oh, it's from the PDW, that cost is fine. No, it's going to be completely wrong. It's not going to be up to date. It's not going to update costs that you're entering in there yourself.
So what if the added cost is $2 because of all these purchasing?
So the key is just to never update cost in this screen.
Okay.
You can update it on the body of your self order, but you never want to touch the pricing in this initial screen that pops up.
Just
leave it as it is.
This is, if he gets a better price, which we know he is.
Well, that price there, that's his blanket price. That's a blanket cost. I know what the blanket cost is, that's why.
Okay.
Now, is that, anybody else picks this item up? Is that what they're going to see?
It depends on how it's generated for the GDW.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons I'm showing you this right now, because I did this, I was doing this the other day when I was playing. I was saying, like, because you guys were telling me, you know, something's in there like this, they're going to pick that cost up. Well, that's a cost of the blanket.
No, wait, did you enter that?
Well, yeah, not in this system, but in the Blue Vista, yes, it's in there at that cost. So that's the.
This is PASTR. Is it possible that our stock is probably close to our.
Not for that. These are one of the things I was bringing up. That's why, like I said, I can play all day with this thing and bring up the stuff, and I got no answers.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
That's just
something we have to look at.
It
could be
yeah.
Something that's. Yeah.
It's all.
The PDW should be calculated with true cost, not a rep cost, which is our replacement cost, which is our everyday
taking that off the screen, so you don't need it. So I'm gonna do something else now. Watch this.
I would imagine right now, the majority of the nonstocks that are populated in there are previously made nonstocks that was in this that carried over.
So that cost would have been traded, would have been changed from trade service, that would have been whatever percentage of the resistance.
I would imagine so, because it's not been set up as trade service, correct? Yeah, so.
So here's another one now.
Yeah. All right.
1,000 each. Okay. That's what I want to do. That's the one I want to do direct.
All right. You want to do that line?
As a direct, but I want also do a PON yet too. Or I'm trying to find an item that I didn't have. But it's a non-stock. I know it's definitely non-stock in the system, and it's probably in our system is that way.
That's a stock item, right?
No, it's not.
So, what's your question?
Well, that's the one I wanted to go and what you call do a non. It's what you call I want to do a PON on. Because okay. I do order those once in a while.
So you want to do?
Let's get the cost put in. So what do you unit cost margin?
So
go to the magnifying glass.
You're selling it, right?
That's the seller.
Yeah, that's your seller right now.
Right,
yeah, I'll get that one in a minute. Yeah, I don't care about the wire price at this point. All right.
Well, the only other thing is your cost is so off in the first one.
Can you go to the cost?
This is
that 242 is what you sell it to.
That's his actual price when it goes out the door. That 4.375, I assume that's what Jim pays for it, but that's not his blanket price.
No, that's our purchase price. That's
right.
Our marked up, fake cost.
That's not. Yeah. Okay. It's your fake cost. That's not what we actually pay for this. It's a blanket, that first item.
Can you
arrive? And this is, no, that's the problem. I was trying to do that the other day, and I don't think it let me do it. Well, maybe, let me see. Yeah, that's what it is, Jim. Good idea, good.
There you go.
Oh, maybe I can now.
Okay,
it didn't let me do it, okay. The other day, they didn't let me do it. Wouldn't let me do it the other day, so.
And now, once you made that change, now next time you go in, if you process this order, next time you went in, those should pop in.
Okay.
Yeah, those are the time you come up and then you pick.
Now, if I had to go back and change that again, I can go back there and change it again. Like come December or January 1st, the blanket's going to probably change because Patty Singer's having a thing. I can go in there and it'll be, okay, that's
and
good.
And then it'll save it.
All right. Now.
You said the blanket was $289, I thought. When you put that item.
No, it was for the TR.
The TRs. I took the TRs out.
Yeah,
I took the TRs out.
All right, so first things first, do you want to do the direct or do you want to do the PO now?
Let's do the direct first, because that's what you wanted to get to anyway, so.
All right, so we're going to do this with the three different generations on the one ticket. So click on the, well, you're in a bid, so we can't source anything in a bid.
Okay, that's the question I have. So I can't do everything on a bid and turn it over, so it takes it as an order.
No, you can't, because you got to be in real-time inventory.
Even on a direct?
Yeah. Because
why? Because you're not using inventory out of stock.
I know.
I'm just asking.
You're still in a bid.
Yeah, but I can do it right now without doing that.
Go ahead. Try and do it now on the scheduling screen. So you're going to let you, you got to click on your wire, right?
Yeah,
you're
going to do it first.
So click anywhere on that row and go to schedule. So now it's taking your ship quantity on that bid. See, I don't know if it'll let you just change it to a direct.
So it says procurable, so.
Try to
change
that ship
quantity.
Okay.
Click on status.
So your status is a C for calling complete. So you want to make it a direct, right?
Yeah.
So change that C to a D for direct.
Where are you
going to
get it from? All right, so before you go any further,
does anybody have any questions about how he did that in scheduling screen? What would have been the other way that he would have done it? We were in already the body of the ticket. But the one thing about that though is that's good if you want everything to be in a direct. So right now we got an order with the pickup, we got an order that's gonna be with a direct, we got an order that's gonna be with a PO now. So if you wanted to have all three options, what would have been the other way of doing a direct? Sources, right? So either way works and either way is easy. What's nice in the scheduling screen is just like he showed you, it's just the click of the drop down of the status. Yeah, I want this to be a direct, boom, and you go right into it. So like anything, you gotta fill out your freight terms. You're gonna do an order ID. Who are you ordering the PO with? The orders with. Who are you going to send it to?
Order with. Yeah, it's good, Mike. It's good enough.
Now, we're going to send this direct to the customer, right?
Yeah.
Do you have any notes that you want for the vendor?
Yeah, vendor. I'm not going
to
fill them.
You're going to your ship to now.
That's not where you're going to put in your address.
Why not? Why not, though? I'm just asking.
Because there's
I mean, I could put them somewhere else, but I'm going to give them instructions. I give them twice. We're talking about Encore here, so. They made enough mistakes in the last couple of weeks for me.
Does anybody know how to change the ship to?
How do we change the ship to?
I got that. I can do that. I can do that. Cool.
Okay, it's under additional.
Under additional, right, isn't it?
Yeah.
I was going to put user tools, but okay. Additional header information, additional address.
Change ship.
Yeah.
Change ship to.
Okay. Customer or blank.
So who are you going to put in there? Who's your customer that we're doing this direct for? Type in the customer's name.
Right there?
Yeah.
No, not there.
Star.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, if you type it there, it's just going to populate their ship to address, and then you can modify it. So if you had their ship to saved in there, you would be able to easily...
I'll ship it to them right now.
Now you would just adjust it. If you wanted to change the address, you would just change it. instructions would be, you know, a phone number to call 24 hours prior.
Oh, you can't put that in the ship tube. I usually put that in the ship tube. That way it's on the ship tube field when it's right there in front of them.
I guess you could. I mean, as a...
Is there a line in there? I don't know if there's another line in there, so, okay. But eventually, I can put the ship tube in there. Okay, no big deal. Okay. All right. So we did that, we did that, we did that. Okay. So I get over here.
Now you want to cut a PO for the second line?
Correct. The third line, actually. Go ahead.
The third, I'm sorry. So, yeah, let's give that a shot. So, click on the item and go to the scheduling screen. You just have to be anywhere on the road. Anywhere on that road.
Oh, it was on
that. Very
good.
You got it.
I had it right
there. Yep. You give it a shot.
Oh, no, that's all I'm called wire over here before. So, okay, so.
So, change that.
Over here, zero.
Yep. Move it to the plenty
there. Yeah, you don't want it
on the direct. So click on that 100.
Zero.
And no.
Why not?
You want to procure it.
Oh. Okay.
So go to your procurement. So you're going to select you're on the PO vendor now because that's the only place that you'd be able to get this from. Put in the amount that you're going to get. And X out.
Well, I want to do something here. I'll place a refill on the place. Oh, you can't do it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, you can't click on it. Just the options.
If you're trying to type something in where already best way or something like that's in there, you have to backspace it out every time. You got to delete it every time. And then you can put in whatever your new should be is going to be.
See if that pops up. So if you don't know exactly how it's inputted in there, if you delete what you have in there and just press F10, it'll bring up the drop down.
Where's priority one? Okay. I guess that'd be next day.
Yep. So X out. Save changes.
What?
Next day isn't.
That's probably right.
Well, FedEx doesn't do next day. FedEx has priority one. Next day is
priority. Right. That's what I think. I think it's priority one is what you call it next day for them. All right. So we're there.
All right. So X out. Now, we got multiple generations on the side here. Okay.
I got that one from CJ.
It says bid on the bottom?
Yeah. I didn't change the order yet.
Because your first item is still as a bid.
Right.
Whereas the others, you see, call them complete and direct.
And the item, so click on the 330.
Click on who?
To the left of your order summary. So do you see how you have the three different totals of your three different generations? So that one, now look at the bottom, how the bottom status has changed. Yeah, exactly. So now you have a new order. Now go to the next generation underneath that. You have your direct. Okay? And it says in red on the bottom, direct. Now you were saying you were having a problem adjusting costs in a direct?
Yeah, it was. At that time, it was, yeah.
So just give it a shot now. Go to your cost and your direct, your line item. Can you change it?
Well, I got a good bite today. Yes, it did. Okay. A lot of white, not white, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Look, I got a little quicker with this now. Now I didn't get through it yet though, hold on. Well, no, I'd have to send it out to him before I do it anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I won't have to send it out as a bid. Yeah. I can't send it out as an order.
I got it. Right. But with this, he could have done all that, and it would still be a bid.
I know.
What do you call it? Is the cost still there?
This one here?
Yeah. Yep, it's there.
On that generation.
That's funny. So if it doesn't show the cost, it means on the direct.
I'm not confusing you guys, am I?
No.
I'm just trying to do something that I would do all day, that's why.
So, here's one thing.
Okay, now.
But I just want to show you this.
Okay.
On that order summary pane to the left, where it has the job name in there, do you see how you have it unchecked?
Yeah, I got to copy all shipments.
Yeah, you want to do copy all shipments, because that's going to be for each generation.
I remember that one too, okay.
All right.
I remember that copy all shipments, I can remember that one. Okay, now, I'm here, new order, blah, 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 blah.
So what's going to be the next step that you want to do?
I got to print it out. Order summary? No. Schedule comment, inventory.
Do you have any directions for the non-stock that's
no.
coming in?
No, I do not. Yeah, I think I did. Do I think you got it?
No, so go to your header.
Yeah, my header. Yeah, I'm right here.
So in your header, don't forget, you have the three different generations. You could have three different instructions on each, so for each generation. So if you used to click on the bid to the left of your order pane, the top one. So in your shipping instructions, do you want that as a counter pickup? Is that a pickup now? Well, no, that's your customer PI.
Oh, I'm in the wrong spot. Hold on. Good for you.
All right. Now click on your call link complete generation. See how the shipping instructions went away? It's a completely different generation. So it's what do you want to do with this ticket? Is this going to be a pickup? Is this going to be delivery? What are you going to do? You're in your PO again.
You're
that's right. I got to change now. Why does it always go back there? Yeah, that's where it's going, right?
It's a mandatory field.
Yeah, but it was in before. There was one in there before, though. Why would it go keep going back to it?
Did that mean he changed the field? Because the default is what you have on the left side there.
Because you also have copied all shipments.
But now notice your PO is shipped to because you changed it.
Yeah, but why would it change from the original one?
The original one was there.
It was there.
Right. I went in, but why didn't it go back to the second one I put in?
Because it always defaults.
Because
it
defaults.
Oh,
there's going to be up something in there.
Yeah. All right. It's always, that's what I'm saying. Okay. Even though, okay.
If you're swapping between generations, it's going to default to that.
All right. Let's go to this one, too, now.
Don't
see, now that came.
Do anything.
All right. Well, that one. So that one came back to the PO. It's already done.
Click on the shipping instructions. All right.
Type whatever you want.
All 24 hours.
Okay. Good.
All right, so let's go to our status. All right, so your bid, do you want to leave it as a bid? Do you want to make it a pickup now? What do you want to do with the bid?
Okay, all right, all right, status, like, how do you stock?
So you have your shipment specified. Because we had it, it was out of stock.
This is what you put for ship tomorrow, right? Realistically, in your instructions, you know, like you wrote ship tomorrow, you don't really have to write when you're shipping it, because your ship date's going
to
explain that. That's more,
you, just have to
you know, leave at back door. Yeah, no,
it makes me, I know.
If you do it. I'm just saying you don't have to, because that ship date's going to be on the ticket. It's going to print that day before.
And so before you go to the next generation, just go to your ship via.
Notice his PO number.
It's only screwed up on that generation. Well, like I say, you're going to have to clear that out. Nope. Just put in PS.
Is there going to be a report at night from, like, that Sam can run at 5 o'clock or, let's say, 5:30 or whatever, 10 minutes before he leaves?
Can't put a little more in PS.
Yeah, PS
Okay.
Your call is complete. Go back to your order status.
I'm in my order status.
No, order still order status in the middle. Where it says call is complete.
Let me make sure.
That was going to be a ship, correct?
Yep.
So you're going to make that a ship when complete.
There's definitely a report like that. See, now that one, without being in here, I can click on it. That makes no sense. I gotta do this on PS over here, truck again?
Yeah, just do PS. You're gonna
PS,
it,
PS,
you're gonna backspace it. Well, you're in the. Quick one over.
So you erase the date.
There you go, you're fine. Do PS 8. Yeah, type of PS, please.
If we just put in PS, would that give us all the lists?
No, because I give you all UPS lists.
It just showed me all of UPS and all like that.
But, like,
all
I'm right. Not going to know which is PS is the least still progressed.
You're not going to have to. As long as you put it on a PS truck, it's going to be on the warehouse.
So, yeah. The best habit to get into, especially while already on the field, is we want to complete that. So you need to cut the PO for that. Well, how do you cut the PO for what you just created? We're doing a generation. So click on the ship when complete. Now the ship went complete. Alright. So you're gonna go to edit. Now what did you do?
Procurement information.
Correct. Now notice in your procure from it just has PO now vendor. That needs to be changed to the vendor that you're getting it from.
You're gonna see.
I would just type in pass.
Just type pass.
There you go. So you gotta check the box, create the PO.
just asked the question, okay, I do a PO now, and it doesn't make freight, like, can I add something to this just for our stock? So, nobody had asked us that before, but the basic simple answer is yes. It's very simple. Literally, from this PO screen, you could just
add something.
Another item. And then you can see that that item isn't going to be tagged in sales order, so somebody was just wondering, you know, what if it doesn't make great? How would I add something just to bring it to stock to our shelves? Very simple. You can do it right from the screen.
What did I have you for? I remember.
$2.
That's it. I ain't doing your orders, no. Good. You entered everything in. I'll put your orders then in. On my screen, yes.
Everybody remember his login.
Everybody remember my login. All right.
All right, so what's the next step?
Along the tabs on the bottom.
Yeah. Detail scheduling? No, no, no. Total status. Right? Status, eh?
Nope. Right after body.
Header. I hate this header thing.
You gotta put in freight
terms. No, I can do that.
Yeah, he can.
Will it show me anything here or no? I gotta put something in.
Got it.
Oh, okay. Did it show me? Okay, $200. Okay, that's prepaid in ad. Okay. It's always going to have to do that, right?
It's a lot easier.
Yeah.
It's not a man for
you.
It's
easier to track your stuff back to your order.
Yeah, when you're going back and looking up like a purchase order inquiry, to have that job in there is huge.
All right, so go to your status.
I got the order
here,
with. Order with. Okay. All right.
So how do you want to send this? Well, the status is going to be
always going to leave it open.
Open, okay.
Yeah.
Just want to make sure. I just want to see what it says. I didn't do this before. No, I'm not. Now, I've done this before. How come this ain't coming up?
Brandon kind of knows a better answer to that.
What?
They're reset for changes. Like where that pops up.
The change log, so if you change something, you can do this. Why did you do this? So this is the reason for change log.
Now, I've done this before. How come it didn't come back up?
What's that?
It didn't carry from doing other ones.
Okay. So that PO is complete for that generation. So the last thing that you got to do is your direct. So first, go to the ship via where it says pickup, backspace, and just put in direct.
I had the 3 times I figured that one out.
All right. Yeah, we're good.
Direct.
Now,
okay.
Before, I just want to see it.
Yeah.
I
didn't take the bill.
Go back to the status.
On the print for the PO by Alcor, see if it gives you anything.
Well, yeah, that's what I want to check. So for your PO to Alcor, click on the drop down where it says print. No,
okay.
The next line down. So to the top, just so you know, the top, that is
right.
your body of the ticket. That's just
next
all it's saying
print.
Is, hey, you're doing a direct, it's going out. The
under
bottom
print,
is your
print.
PO. Nope.
Under print.
Go to print.
There you go.
You hit the drop down.
Yeah, see.
So that's fine. You can do all that. We still need, you know.
And the
So it still didn't let me do it yet.
Yeah.
But we're doing
the
other day.
Right. That should, this should just look just like you're doing a PO now.
It should look the same where we have
it should be the same
fax, email.
So it won't allow me to send it out yet.
Right. And so do you know how to go to, how you email it?
We did, but we had to do through the options right before we were checking.
Yeah.
That's all we have capabilities.
So if you wanted to email that PO to yourself because you're going to send it over to Mike, you got options? Right there at the bottom, it says print, fax, email. To that email.
I did, I changed. I didn't like it.
Okay, fine. All right, so exactly. Now, your shift via is going to be what's going to carry on to that PO. So, is this something that they're sending red? Is it just standard best way? How are they going to send it?
I don't fucking know.
Best way.
Best way.
Should it be best way?
Okay.
All right, so your shift way, your shift via for your PO?
That's here now, right?
Yep.
Yeah, it came up. Okay, good.
All right. Any questions?
No, we don't have a capability for it. Or at least I don't. And Dave, Carol, Dave, the rest of the
job. You don't have the ability of doing what? And
anything with that direct. You can't change the shift via or otherwise. Once you create that direct, because it says a PO, you can't manipulate anything.
The consolidated. So I want you to know, see what it did to your status. You had a ship one specified on there, right? Now it's going to ship tomorrow. So since you consolidated back orders, it's going to put it with that. It's not going to ship until that ship one complete comes in.
Oh, okay.
You know, it's putting everything together. So it's that just cancels your shipping.
Now, why are you
on the original one?
So why were you trying to consolidate the back orders?
I don't like to see all this writing.
You don't like to see all that writing?
Too much stuff. There's way too much information. Yeah. I wanted to see one information. That's all I wanted to see is one thing.
Yeah, but
you want to do like three different things on one thing.
See, I mean, it's a good thing. Show what you just did. Show it again and show.
All right, guys, right there. Basically, I want like this.
Well, your ship dates and everything are still the same, whether the generations there are not.
Well, you went to manage shipments, right?
Yeah, manage shipments. I hit. I clicked it.
Consolidate back orders.
Right.
So basically.
So I'd have to go back here and.
You would have to change it
back to where it was. Okay. Well, okay. So
what your consolidate back orders is going to do is, let's say you did have a large ticket with a bunch of different back orders on it. Something that was going to be like a pack.
This is done now, right?
And you wanted everything to go together. You would consolidate the back orders, and what it's going to do is it's going to push it to the latest date of the last item to come in.
Ah, see that? Okay.
But it's going to pick the whole. It's going to pick the oldest.
See, once you do all that, I can't kill it out of the system.
Yeah, but you also see what's kind of thrown off too is the fact that he's got a direct on there.
Well, the direct is separate, but I'm talking about you've got all the complete show 11-14 and ship went complete on 11-13.
Well, the reason why the ship went complete also changed was because he accidentally wiped it out and remodeled it. Yeah, so it would send everything on 11-14. If that's how it would send to come in. And that's another thing that you could do to get things on the same generation. Is that all you'd have to do is change the date. So if you had two things on 11-13, you had something on 11-14, you're like, you know what, I want everything to go on that 11-14. Go to that 11-13, change it to 11-14, it's gonna push it on the same generation.
Yeah.
Exactly. You good?
Yeah, give me another day where I'm off. I can play with this a little more. Come up with some more things I don't understand, but it's okay.
Are there any questions you got about the reps?
No, not yet. I do, but I gotta have to do it myself for a while.
Did you want to try creating a nonstop from scratch?
No, not yet.
Not yet?
Not yet. Let's get the main stuff here. Not yet. No problem. Thank you, guys.
So, Graham, I want to pick your brain real quick. This is something that we just started in Tim Falls, and you probably have a better answer for us. One, when you guys did deliveries at Cooper's, did you use a manifest?
Manifest, no. The counter, if you were a sales counter, you would use manifest was for...
My point is, use the manifest on like an iPad or whatever to do the lifts.
Yeah.
That's how they log it, that's how they're.
And so you take your ship labels and I'll give you like the other thing that we can get was like an IDT's one of the branch, you use manifest for that. And you can put more than one, let's say like transfer number, if that's what they IDT and ship labels and transfers. So okay. You can use one manifest but put multiple. This item has to go for this ticket, this item has to go for their stock, this has to go for this, but it'll all be on one hand.
Okay. So what we just started messing around with today, and we kind of just did like a little mock run, was we did two quick orders for delivery. We threw them on the iPad for a manifest, set it all up, gave it to our driver, had our driver go out, and did the drop-offs. Okay? Came back, let's go close out the manifest. Right. What's good about this and what everybody's going to be able to see is that you're going to have your driver on the road and it's going to show X amount of time away from where, and you're going to have real-time tracking on the driver's. Because there's no hard copy, unless, wait, I know, can't refuse anything?
Can't refuse that. The mobile drivers have the order on, what they basically see on their iPad, when they see the order, and so they can manipulate, like, okay, he's taking up before he signs, he doesn't want the 100,
no, they should be
one in three machine straps, and then hit a button, and
so,
like, okay, that
way. But before you go into that, though, is that there is a way, it will pull up the order, but pictures are going to be attached. Not physically taking pictures, but like manufacturer, like off website, of what the items are. Okay? So that one, because we've always had this mistake, especially new drivers, of grabbing EMT instead of PPC and this and that. Well, now on the iPad, especially in the order, it's going to show, oh, it's a great pipe. You know what I mean? So it's going to show you a picture of what all of the material is.
But I don't think the iPad will tell you. Today it showed like carbon quantities, reel quantities, coils, lengths, but it's not going to give like individual SKUs, I don't think.
It'll show the customer, it'll show the order number, and like he said, it'll show
four cartons.
Cartons,
same.
then it's the same thing, how you create a manifest is the same thing. It's a separate queue. You can either scan all your tickets into the manifest, manually enter them, and that's how the manifest populates.
Now, is that done at the time the order is pulled, or is that going to be done when the truck goes out? My question being is because buying stuff like that,
right,
we typically don't pull for that morning.
Right, so I would think, I would think for the morning run, those manifests are going to be created that morning. Because there's also, we were talking, there's also going to be stuff coming in from IBTs that probably has to go out on that run. So, I mean, today, warehouse managers typically set the run in the morning, I think. So, I think those shipping manifests will also be created first thing in the morning. And then, obviously, any same-day deliveries has to go on a manifest, and then you create it right then and there for the same day.
So, basically, the guys in the warehouse are going to pull material from the ship ticket and mark it up as they would now a regular ticket.
Right.
And then the warehouse manager, whoever in the morning, has to scan them all in and set whatever quantities marked on there to the system for their matter.
Quantities marked. Are you talking about like the cart
box,
that stuff? Well, that can be done right after. That should be done right after the order. That's a separate function of doing that, of the carton counts and all that stuff, which I think should be done right after the order is pulled. So an order picker doesn't have to be the warehouse manager that does that. That could be any warehouse guy that can go into that queue, can hop on the computer.
And that's done from the mainframe, or is that done from tablets or whatever?
No, that should be done from the mainframe. That would be done from a PC. So you got a
hand.
And the other thing too is the manifest going to set up the delivery in the most logistically sound way, or is it going to be the warehouse manager who sets up what delivery goes in which order?
He's gonna still set it up as what delivery goes in what order.
Okay, so the system's not going to do it in terms of like most logistically.
It's it's gonna. The warehouse manager will set the order.
So
the way
it's not like his office.
But see, that's the thing too.
No warehouse manager's leaving their office.
But see, but that's the thing too, though, is all requests are going to also have to come through the warehouse manager, especially for the changes. You know what I mean? We can't have every salesman calling every driver because they can see where they're at. And they're like, oh, hey, you're 5 minutes away from this guy right here.
Okay.
No. It's got to go through the warehouse manager, and they're going to.
I don't think anybody that does that.
No, how would we see that?
Because you can pull up the delivery truck.
Get back to your
original. Where are you doing that?
It's called a NOVA.
If we go back to the original question, how to start, what you said?
Yeah, what's
the
usual?
You never answered the question.
That's also
shipping ticket still stays open.
Right.
How to get closed out?
That, as far as I know, once they get the signature loaded from the delivery, it's supposed to close like automatically somehow. I'm gonna have to do a little undercover research.
Salesmen would be closing out their deliveries.
No.
Which I don't, and like I said, I don't know how that would work.
Yeah, but again, that's something we have to figure out, but.
Isn't there a sandwich?
But
just. I mean, who's filling the drafts? You've got to have a family to fill the drafts.
Yeah, that's not going to be so.
But
still. Pulling here, but for every day,
yeah. Your suggestion is for the warehouse.
I don't want it to be me.
No, I'm just thinking. No. It is. No, when I tell a salesman from each store that they have to come, I'm going to say it was your idea. Yeah. Okay, but no, I get. I just.
The only problem I have is people
when
you get that. I understand.
Yeah.
Depends on vacation. If someone else is going to have to leave.
No, right.
Well, I saw it's got to be someone
who's actually. Well, I thought your point was that when we do these, when we set up these warehouse trainings, your point was to also have one salesman representing.
Me as the quote unquote backup warehouse, I mean, someone from the sales.
That's what I. That's right. Because they're going to pose some questions. Yeah.
That they might not ask them. They're going to need to know. They want to know what's going to happen with their products.
He does both. Yeah. Right. Okay. No, that's a good thought. That's a good thought.
So Dave's going to all meetings. Got that. Yeah, that's
good.
Oh, no,
where are
you? I said Omar.
Omar?
No.
Omar's
senior. I don't know.
That's not advice.
No, it was not, nothing to do with that. I'm saying Omar is going to be in every department of the
stuff. Say you send, right, like now they sign tickets with everything on it, right? Mm-hmm. The guy who's at the job is, you know, he's got to call the bus to make sure everything's there. He's not going to report it. They're not going to be able to see what's on there.
What do you mean?
Like, you do a ticket, right? The guy's boss calls in and says, hey, I need this order for this job tomorrow. Every day when he gets that job, his boss usually wants to check the order.
Yeah, he's supposed to check
the individual.
So,
it's just an individual life.
If you order one bus, if you order this, if you order this, no.
And there are still going to be customers that are going to want a hard copy.
Yeah, right. Or the ship ticket? Or the pick ticket, I mean?
I mean, you could send a ship ticket, but I mean, it's going to be a...
Well, let me ask, why would the ship ticket be a pain in the ass for him to take?
Well, I just don't remember, like, because I know that you're saying there's not going to be ship ticket being brought to the customers, correct? It's just going to be a sign there.
I think we still have to have a hard copy.
Okay, well, then yeah.
Okay, because I was under the impression there would be no hard copy to be assembled at NHTSA.
But you will have that guy who's a dick who's not going to sign for anything until he's got a check first.
Yeah.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. First of all, guys, I know what you're saying about the guys taking from the PDF. That's pretty good. You have one that you don't want the main guy signing for. Those are guys signing for.
Yeah.
Or laborers.
Yeah.
Go to journeyman. No, he was just. They're just signing. They ain't checking. They're just signing. They're not going to worry about PDF to the boss. Like I said, a lot of my guys block those copies. They go back to the office. They match up to the report places.
Well, sure, even if it's defaulted, or even if it's defaulted, like whatever that ticket gets blown, it automatically sent to whoever you want to sign.
Oh, it can't do that.
Remember when I was. Yeah, we used to have that set up for our guys. It was literally as soon as it was signed.
No matter who signed for it, it goes to that person.
Whoever you wanted to sign.
Yeah, so,
and they can see who signed for it, what was on it, blah, blah, like in real time.
Okay, that's right.
But guys, if you're sending a PDF to somebody like Carl Shepard at Century or Anthony at North Jersey Power, you're putting it onto their cell phone. They're on a job site. They want to check the 25 miles of money I just sent to them and have it all. It's hard for them to do it on the screen. I'm not sure how we're getting rid of paper. I don't know how the customers.
Well, I know for us on our end, we wouldn't need. So, and that's what we were talking about today, is that if we're doing a delivery and we have a ship ticket that printed in the back, yeah, everything's loaded in the manifest. We are going to have guys that want emails. We are going to want guys that want a hard copy. We'll give them that ship ticket as a hard copy.
Send a copy of the ticket that they actually used to pick with the material.
Well, no, we're going to send them.
You'll always have the option to give paper to the driver and say, hey, I need
this. Use the ticket that we used to pull it, whatever.
So I just hold on. So this is
all right. So real quick,
just give us like 5 more minutes and then we'll have
that. So wait, yeah, this is just real quick what I wanted to show you, because this is the example we did today. This order that's up on the screen, and so we put it on the manifest. Driver took it with his iPad. We had it, you know, we put a signature in. So like I was saying, when you go back into the sales order, there's this little icon on the top right that if you click on that, this will pop up, and then you can view documents from that sales order. So the signature, whether they uploaded a picture, you can click on that.
So we don't have to wait for POD.
Right. Wow, okay. This is insane. All right, I've never done it on an iPad. Oh, wait, maybe this is it. Yeah, there's a signature. It's right there. And JSON.
Oh, no, the guy printed his name.
But you notice, okay, so this was signed for, right? If you go to the status, though, it still says a ship on this date. So it doesn't say it's invoiced yet, even though the signature was done on the iPad, the manifest was closed out. They got the material. So we're trying to figure out is how this delivery actually gets invoiced, where like a counter pickup, we're saying, is invoiced right when they sign and go. Deliveries aren't. So that's where my dad had this whole idea that the salesman would be kind of closing out their deliveries. Obviously, you're saying that's not how it was done at Cooper, so we're trying
but
to figure that out.
I was dropping delivery. I really didn't touch it after that and use it the next day and say if I went back and got a ticket, it would show it
as invoice?
Yes.
Right, so we're trying to figure out how that. Yeah, well, each manifest gets closed once the whole thing is done.
Okay.
Right? But the status of the order still stays open. So we're just trying to figure out how that gets in.
Don't they have a lot of customers on this system already? Don't they have anybody to recommend? Or they're just computerized that because they're just so big and they're more child on computer helping them
customizable, and the way we're doing things are so different than the way Cooper does things, and so we see what we have to do, and you know, we're coming across all these things and it's blocking us, then we kind of have to go to Jimbo and say, listen, we need to be able to do this stuff, can we do it, and it's got to go back and forth. It's like, it's a whole process, that's why these answers haven't been done yet.
Unless you want to show miscellaneous charges real quick.
Yeah.
That was in this class I've had.
Yeah. It's not going to be correct. So real quick, this will take 1 second. This is going to answer some questions too. It's about the miscellaneous charges. So very simple. You're just going to put in MISC. MISC. And there's going to be your list of your miscellaneous charges. Parallel charges, your freight to follows, everything. Yes.
On your actual PO, you put freight to follow. Why would you put on the PO?
Well,
it doesn't already have a freight terms thing?
Well, it's got freight terms in there, but sometimes, you know, just as whatnot.
You would put freight to follow on your invoice. Yeah, I feel like you would want freight to follow on your invoice, but you wouldn't need it on the direct going to the manager. Yeah, I guess.
Sometimes we have small order charges.
Oh, yeah, you're right. And cut charges and stuff like that.
So I'm trying to tie it to the direct, and it actually created another direct. Unlike the PLN where you tie it to the one vendor, it was creating another direct PLN.
So when you do a freight to follow, what would you do as your status?
Yeah, because it's going to be a different line.
No. It's going to be different. I'm talking about, let's say we're doing a non-stock and there's going to be freight to follow, it's for a charge customer. It's its own line, it's its own generation.
When you do a call and complete, you don't feel like
you do, exactly. You do,
right.
You do call and complete.
Yeah, but I was doing it as a direct, trying to put it on the board.
You did it all the way from the beginning of already in a direct order
itself. I'm just doing
not as a direct order, I'm assuming there's an individual
left. No, but were you in a direct?
I was in a ticket and I created a direct line.
But that's my question, is how
how did you create the direct line?
Alright,
do it like that because I gotta see something.
Not this way?
No, don't do it this way. Did you, alright, hold on.
Just as we did it before from sourcing, that
yep.
would be how long it would be.
Got it. Alright, so do it here. Put in, one and then do THN 400. All right, so you were here, you went to other vendor, and you did direct full quantity.
Exactly.
And we did encore.
Yep.
Yada, yada.
And you did your freight line, too?
Yep.
Or
so now this is where you did your freight follow.
Yep.
Now, you wanted to have that on the direct PO,
yeah.
But you also wanted it on
the
order. So I think you would have to do it like this.
Schedule.
No.
Because it shows that you have it.
Put it right there.
Yeah, but you're taking it off. Aren't you taking it off the...
Yeah, but when you do it direct, you're directing your
yeah,
sales
you
order exact same.
Yeah, exactly. So see where he is in the scheduling screen? And he just moved it from
my pickup
from
now.
His pickup now to the one
direct.
Direct.
Okay.
That is what I want to do.
Yeah,
so X out.
On that from the schedule.
Yeah.
So X out.
Okay.
So now it should all be on one
so
generation.
Now it's all on the same generation.
Right.
That's how I would do it.
Yeah. If whenever you want to take an item, any item that is, even a freight to follow, because technically it's created in the system as an item. It's the same thing. You go into the scheduling, you're taking it off your body of the ticket right now, you're throwing it on that direct. You could do that. He could add another line item right now. It doesn't matter what it is. The authority.
Yeah, it'll change.
All right.
All right.
So we'll just take that, go to schedule. So he wants to throw that on.
So I was already on the direct.
Oh, he's already on the direct.
So now anything I add will be on the direct, yeah.
Yeah.
How would I change that? What if I didn't want that on the direct release?
If you didn't want that on the direct, what would you do?
Then he would have to change the pickup now or whatever he wants.
Yeah, but it's not there.
It's not there. It's all on the direct.
He's only got the whole release.
Yeah, so you would have to just take it off this direct date.
But you can change the status now.
That just created a new direct for it.
Yeah. Change the status.
Let's change this.